The dodong is also making its presence felt in Cagayan and Isabela. Let's get an update now from our very own Harris Julio. He joins us on the line. Harris, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, the province of Cagayan is experiencing bad weather due to tropical depression dodong. According to the State Weather Bureau, dodong's last known location is within the vicinity of Alacapan, Cagayan. At around 9:14 this morning, heavy downpour was felt in Claveria, Cagayan, as shown from the video taken by teacher Emily Lorenzo. Because of this, the provincial government has suspended the classes of public and private schools from preschool to senior high school throughout the province earlier today. Meanwhile, the province of Isabela, which is also under signal number one, is experiencing gloomy weather and intermittent rains. In the coastal town of Dinapigay, where dodong made landfall around 3 a.m., there was no significant effect and only light rain was experienced according to the Municipal Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office. The sea condition is already moderate to rough, prompting authorities to strictly implement the no-sail policy. The liquor ban is also being enforced throughout the province. The Magadam administration is also closely monitoring the rains brought by Typhoon Dodong. We hope this will help increase the water level in the dam's reservoir. It has dropped significantly in recent days due to the lack of rain and the effects of El Nino. The Office of the Civil Defense Region 2 has also raised the blue alert status for local governments and other government agencies to prepare for the possible impact of tropical depression.
Wind signal number one is up over parts of Luzon as tropical depression Dodong moves northwestward. Let's get the latest now from PAGASA weather forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Lori?
Good morning, ma'am, and to all our viewers and listeners. Dodong maintains its strength as it moves north-northwestward over the northwestern Cagayan area. And its center was last estimated at the vicinity of the Alacapan, Cagayan. With maximum sting winds of 45 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 75 kilometers per hour, and its movement is still north-northwestward at 15 kilometers per hour. With this, tropical cyclone signal number one still raised over Cagayan, Isabela, Apayao, Kalinga, Abra, Mountain Province, Ifugao, Benguet, Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, and the northern portion of Pangasinan. Meanwhile, cloudy skies with rains due to southwest monsoon can still be experienced over the rest of Luzon, over Visayas, and some parts of Mindanao, particularly the Zamboanga Peninsula. That's the latest from PAGASA. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Classes have been suspended in the province of Ilocos Sur due to tropical depression Dodong. Randy Menor now joins us with an update on the situation there. Randy, over to you.
Yes, Carmina. Farmers in Ilocos Norte are hoping of a much-needed rain brought by tropical depression Dodong. They needed the rains because most of them not yet planted rice due to the lack of water. As of now, Ilocos Norte and its neighboring provinces remains under tropical cyclone wind signal number one and experiencing moderate to heavy rains. Most of the rice fields in Ilocos Norte are rain-fed or relies on rainfall for water. Farmers said that they are now behind in the usual planting season and the month of June and July. They also feared of the possible effect of El Nino and the scarcity of water. On the other hand, the provincial city and municipal disaster risk reduction and management office are already on alert status of the possible effect of tropical storm Dodong. They are monitoring coastal barangays, particularly fishermen, and advise not to go on fishing due to Dodong. Meanwhile, in Ilocos Sur, Governor Jerry Simpson suspended the classes in schools in all levels, public and private today, due to tropical storm or tropical depression Dodong. And that's the latest in Ilocos Norte and Ilocos Sur. Reporting for ANC, Randy Menor, ABS-CBN News.
Tragedy in San Fernando, Cebu, where two teenagers drowned at sea amid the bad weather. Our very own Annie Perez now joins us with that story. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina. A lot of incidents happened here in Cebu yesterday because of the inclement weather that we're experiencing. Firstly, 15 individuals or four families in Sipulangub, Barangay Buhisan, are in evacuation even until today due to a landslide that occurred in this area. According to Barangay Buhisan Captain Gremar Barrete, the incident was triggered by a heavy downpour. As of now, a cordon is set up in the area and no resident can go near the landslide site, and they are temporarily siding at the barangay hall. The responders are also clearing the area. Over in the provincial road of Sitio Happy Valley, Barangay Candagit in Sibonga, Cebu, a rockslide was also logged per its local police office. Several areas were also flooded anew in Cebu, such as major thoroughfares in Mandawi City. Its City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office noted three areas that were impassable: Barangay Tipolo to Barangay Subangdako, AS Fortuna Street, and AC Cortez Avenue. Cebu City is also expediting the clearing of waste materials that were stacking up in a major river that has been identified as the cause of flood in its downtown area. Over in Sikihor, two trips in Dumaguete City, Negros Oriental were cancelled by the Philippine Coast Guard due to bad weather. Meanwhile, just this morning, two teenagers were found dead by the coast of Panataran in San Fernando, Cebu. According to Police Senior Master Sergeant Marvin Ando, the investigator of San Fernando Police Station, the victims were 13 and 16 years old. Allegedly, they were bathing in the sea yesterday and were told by local residents to get out as the rain started. However, the teenagers identified as Jocel Apao and Frances Ramirez did not heed to this call. There were also originally three of them, but one was able to reach the shore in time. Authorities said the waves were big yesterday, noting inclement weather in San Fernando. They were declared missing last night, and after a search and rescue operation, their cadavers were found early this morning by members of the Philippine Coast Guard and the National Police. Authorities are now reminding the public to be cautious as the State Weather Bureau issued multiple heavy rainfall advisories in most areas of Central Visayas, noting that this is due to the trough of the tropical depression that recently entered the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest here in Central Visayas. Ani Perez, ABS-CBN.
The Philippine Public Works and Highways Department now investigating the horrendous traffic buildup that occurred at the South Luzon Expressway Thursday. Motorists found themselves in standstill traffic after flooding hit the SLEX's Bikutan exit in Parañaque City. Authorities say, aside from the heavy rainfall, the flooding was also caused by the drainage works of a nearby mall.
Responsable naman ang SM, makikipagtulungan po sa amin yan, kaya po kami mag-uusap-usap tungkol po. Magpapadala ng ating mga inhinyero para makita po kung gaano kalawak ang naapektuhan nitong nung pagbabara po.